the middle of Melbourne, there's literally a little piece of England. A little stone and brick cottage, which was dismantled in England, brought out here, and rebuilt. It's often known as Captain Cook's Cottage, but that's wrong. He almost certainly never stayed there. It was built by his parents, and their names, or their initials, for James and Grace Cook, and their date for building the cottage, 1755, are still carved above the front door. It's a beautiful little cottage, but what's it doing out here? It's been rebuilt here, stone by stone and brick by brick. And how on earth do you do a thing like that? Well, with a fair bit of preparation. Here's a photo of the cottage as it was back in England. And before dismantling it, an architect had to go around and draw the whole thing, and draw every stone, and put a number on the stone, and also on the plan that he'd drawn of it. So every single bit of it was registered on a drawing of it. Then the thing was pulled down, very carefully. And that's a picture of it being dismantled in England. And all the bits and pieces were loaded into a boat and brought halfway across the world to our country. And you can see them there in the bottom of the boat, each with their own code and number. Well, how then was it put up? Again, very carefully, using the architect's plan. That's a somewhat simplified version, but it'll give us the idea. And all the stones, of course, were rather like children's blocks. And working from the plan, they were simply placed back in the right orientation and the right relationship to each other. So that there with stones 6, 7 and 8, you've got the bottom row. Then the next row was added, and the next row, leaving room for the window. And finally, the roof was put in place. And of course, there would have been the other walls as well, but we've only shown the front. And you can see, comparing it with the plan, we've got Cook's Cottage recreated across the world. And it stands today in Melbourne the way it stood in England when Captain Cook's parents lived in it. All the stones are in place, and so are the bricks. And so are the tiles, which are rather curious S-shaped tiles known as pantiles. They're characteristic of the part of Yorkshire from which this cottage comes. It's got ivy growing on it. In fact, that is growing from a cutting taken from the original cottage in England. No one knows what the cottage's garden really looked like. So this is a recreation of cottage gardens of that type, with vegetables growing in the back and flowers growing out in the front. Today, Cook's Cottage is a museum. You can go inside it and look at the interior. And in the stable, there's an exhibition of Cook, his life and his voyages. But that's not the only part of Old England that you'll find in the Fitzroy Gardens. Nearby, there are other old buildings, Tudor buildings, but they are much smaller. There's a recreation of a Tudor village here. In part, it's imaginary, the sort of village that might have existed, but there are some famous buildings. Anne Hathaway's cottage is there, and so is Shakespeare's birthplace. So if you want to see a bit of Old England, the cheapest way is simply to visit Melbourne.